Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today I will be passing over to Carl Poulin. He's going to do an amazing overview of the top 10 Todoist tips. So if you're a Todoist user or you're looking to use Todoist, these will give you some of the insights into how to optimize and improve your current experience. Now, before we dive in, please do make sure before you enter this video to subscribe to Carl here on YouTube. He does amazing videos from everything from iOS reminders to a new series about iCloud storage to Todoist and Evernote. And you will absolutely love his channel if you are watching this video on Keep Productive. So subscribe and you'll find a massive amount of value from Carl. But Carl, thank you so much for coming on. I will let you take it away. And a big thank you again for preparing this video.
Okay, my first tip is, where possible, use the native apps. Don't rely solely on the web versions. The web versions are very, very good, but when you use the native apps, you get the ability to use things like the keyboard shortcut. So in this case, I got the quick entry. This is universal across any page that I'm in. I can quickly add, in my case, Shift Command A, which this is my second tip, by the way. I can get the keyboard shortcut to bring this up. I can also use Shift Command T. Now, this is just my choice. You can create these for yourself. Shift Command T will bring Todoist up into my list. So that's something I really wanted to show you. So the first tip is, where possible, use the native apps. Download the native apps to your computer and laptops. The next tip is, get to use the keyboard shortcuts. Now, to do the keyboard shortcuts, you're going to Todoist Preferences, and where it says shortcuts, you can do show hide Todoist, and you can create your own. So you just create, if it's got some standard ones in there, just hit the cross button and then record your own. Or quick add entry, which to me is the game changer for me, because I use this every single day, which is Shift Command A. As I say, you can change that. You can create whatever you want. That is a key part of getting stuff into Todoist, and it gets it straight into your Todoist. Number three is, create your own dashboard. Now, I have my dashboard, you can see it right here, which is P inbox today and waiting for. To set your dashboard, you first need to go into filters and create a dashboard filter. I've got mine here. I'll show you what it says here. So edit filter. I've got P inbox overdue today and waiting for. This is the order that it will show up with on the screen. And this is specifically created so that when I open Todoist every morning, this is my dashboard view. This is the view that I see, and that's all I have to do. So if I'm ever in, wherever I am in Todoist, I can just go straight to my dashboard. To get to your dashboard, to set your dashboard, go into Settings and General, and right up at the top there, it says Start Page Dashboard. You can choose any of your filters or projects, anything really, but you can create your very own by using the projects or the filters, which is down at the bottom. As you can see, mine is the dashboard view. Okay, number four is to create a start page on your mobile device based on what you want to see normally when you open the app. Now, I have a start page on my phone, which is actually today's focus, and these are the ones that I've got coming up today, as you probably already know, which is the three tasks that I have left for today, my today's focus. Now, to create the start page is, if you go to Settings right up here and you go into, I believe it's your General, we're going to find this, and there you go, you've got start page right up at the top there, and as you can see, mine is set for today's focus. You can choose filters, you can choose labels, you can choose projects, you can choose whatever you want as your start page. In my case, I use a filter, which I created especially for this. Well, actually not for this. It's my today's focus. These are the 10 tasks that I want to see each day. It's a real game changer, because when you open up Todoist, you see that page. That's the first thing you see. A really, really useful tip for you there. Next up, while we're on the phone, is make sure that your Todoist is in a very easily locatable place. So as you can see right here, mine is on my phone. It's right there on the left, right-hand side, because that's how I would normally pick it up. It's in a, right at the edge. I can get to it very, very quickly. Number six is, create a today list for your 10 most important tasks. Now, I call mine today's focus. I'm very lucky because today I only have three things there. I don't allow this today's focus, and my This is actually a filter that I've created. I'll go into my filters and show you this. Today's focus. My filter, I'm using the flags for this. So it's today and not P4. So anything I have flagged, I'm only allowing myself to have 10 flags per day. And that could be red flag, orange flag, and blue flag. But don't allow yourself to have more than 10 flagged tasks per day, and then create a filter for it. And the reason for that is when you create a filter for this kind of thing, it is not overwhelming. Now, as I say, today I'm very fortunate because at the time of recording, I only have 3 tasks left, which is to complete these YouTube videos and also to prepare this week's newsletter and send out the newsletter. I only have these 3 tasks left to do today. I feel I'm on fire, but that is something. When you have 10 tasks in there, it's not overwhelming, and it also forces you to prioritize so that you actually get the right stuff done. Next up is, once you've got that today list, is to spend 10 to 15 minutes at the end of the day doing what I call the closing down session. And basically what you do is, I've got today, so any task that, this is my filter for this, and I'll show you again. I'm gonna go into my, I call it my golden 10, and I've lost it. It's right there, golden 10. If I go in there and show you that one, edit the filter, all I've got here is it's 2 days, so it's the next 2 days and not P4. This tells me, make sure that I'm not doing any more than 10 tasks tomorrow. It also shows any of the tasks that I have not done today. So that 10 to 15 minutes allows you to actually go in and you can actually do your processing of your inbox and then making sure your 10 tasks for the day. Trust me on this one, it sets you up for a fantastic day, and you can just create a really simple filter for that. Okay, and if you are a iOS user on the Apple Watch and an Apple Watch user, then you've got this Drafts app here. This is fantastic. This is a new task, and I have no idea how to spell. So this is a new task, and I can just quickly send that to Todoist, which I have right there, and it's gone. And you probably just, I did that so fast you didn't see. So this is another task, and I'll show you from the drop down menu. And you can go to my frequently used ones, Todoist. I'm going to do multiple tasks in Todoist. Bang, and it's gone. So now when I open up my Todoist, you will see in my inbox that these 2 tasks have just come in. It's a game changer when you want to capture things really quickly using your iOS device. Next one is to do your weekly review on your desktop or laptop. You see, you need the extra space. So when you're doing a week review, I've got up here active projects. So I can go in here, I can go through all my various active projects in there. I've got my tickler file, I can go through my ticklers and just to make sure single actions are all in here. So I've got all this and I can just go through things one by one, step by step, within my projects. It's much, much easier doing it on a desktop or through the web than it is to do it through your mobile devices, which is a lot more difficult. The screen space is very limited, and you'll find you're in a much easier way, more relaxed way to do your weekly review on a desktop or laptop. Next up, number 10 is, when you create filters, think about what you want to see. Now, don't try and copy someone else's filters. I've given you a brief glimpse of my filters here. I have quite a lot of them. I don't use them all, to be perfectly honest. These, a lot of them have been used for demo purposes. But don't try and copy someone else's filters. When you're using somebody else's filters, everything goes wrong. You need to think about what you want to see in a filter, and there's so many things that you can do, and I'm sure that Francesco will link to Todoist filters help page, which is brilliant because it's full of so many different things. And number 11, I have a real bonus for you here, and this is just some general advice about any productivity system you might be using, is don't copy someone else's system. Create your own system, because you have unique ways of working, you have unique ways of thinking, and it needs to work for you, not for somebody else. So my bonus tip is, when you're setting up your Todoist, don't go looking at other people's and trying to copy it. By all means, get ideas from other people, but create your own system, a system that works for you. So thank you very much for watching these 10 tips. I hope you found them useful. My name is Carl Pauline, and it would be great to see you over in my YouTube channel, where I can help you every week with tips and tricks on Todoist. And just a big, big thank you to Francesco for allowing me to put this top 10 Todoist tips, that's a mouthful, together. Thanks very much.